People pleasers pride themselves on self-sacrifice. They see themselves as noble and as a cure to all the selfishness out there. But unfortunately, they are majorly deluded. Self-sacrifice is where you put your own needs aside and prioritize the needs and wants and desires of others. It's where you hurt to help. And I used to do this a lot. In fact, I lived for this. I saw myself as kind of the last great guy, the last nice guy left. And I would constantly be looking for opportunities where I could help someone else and benefit their lives and make them happy at the cost of my own. If you look around, you'll see this all the time, and you're probably one yourself. The overworked and tired parents, the caring friends who drop everything for their other friends, the hard workers who don't know how to say no at the office. We're surrounded by people pleasers. I personally think a majority of people suffer from this particular disease. And they have this idea that helping doesn't really count unless it hurts you personally. You have to suffer to help others, or otherwise it's not really helping. So today we're going to explore three of the main problems with being a self-sacrificing people pleaser and what you can do differently to be even more helpful. Problem number one, you're serving from a weak place. The big wake-up call that I got about my own self-sacrifice actually came at a strange moment. I was in an aeroplane and they were doing the safety standard procedure, talking about, you know, how to put on your seatbelt and all that stuff that they always do. And then it came to the bit where the oxygen mask drops down, and they said a very specific line: make sure you adjust your own mask before helping the child next to you. Now at the time I thought that was incredibly selfish, like, what kind of selfish bastard would put their own mask on when there's a poor child sitting next to them? And then it clicked. If I don't put on my mask and I'm suffocating and struggling and I'm trying to jam this mask on this poor kid next to me while I'm like, and now the kid's struggling and suffering too and being forced, you know, to do things the way I want them done and all this, we both die, right? We're both fucked. But if I let that kid suffer just a little bit while I get my shit sorted, then I'm going to be a fully functioning, healthy, breathing adult who can now help this kid. And that help will be very powerful and useful, as opposed to being helped by somebody who's also suffocating. And this is the problem with self-sacrifice: they burn themselves out, drain their own resources, neglect themselves, and then they're helping from a suffocating place. They're really not that helpful. If you've ever been helped by somebody who's clearly struggling, and the guilt you feel and how poor their help is, how often they make mistakes and how bad you feel about the suffering they're going through just to help you, then you understand what I'm talking about. And this is the problem with most people pleasers. Their help is actually like 50% of what they could do because they're not taking care of themselves first. A classic example of this is a child who's got an overprotective and overcaring parent. The parent does everything for them, the child doesn't have to do any chores or anything, the parent solves all the child's problems and won't let them hurt themselves and their experiments and so on. This child grows up fragile and spoiled and kind of bubble wrapped, and then they go out into the real world and they fall to pieces because they're not prepared for the pain of the real world and for the responsibilities of taking care of yourself. So how can you really say that that parent was helping that child when all they were doing was setting them up for failure? When you help someone from a weak place, when you're suffocating them and yourself with your support, nobody wins. It's far more effective for you to get your own shit sorted while letting other people try and sort themselves out, and then when they really can't, you step in as a healthy, confident person and give them a hand. Problem number two, your so-called self-sacrificing intentions are actually very selfish. Take a moment to have an honest look in the mirror, metaphorically speaking. Why do you sacrifice yourself? Get past the initial lie you tell yourself about how you're a good person and how you're making the world a better place and how you're helpful, and get down to the meat of this. You want to be seen as the hero. You want sympathy. You want to be appreciated. You want a reputation as a good person. You want other people to see you as a good person. Maybe you want to be a good mother or a good father or a good friend or a good partner. And mostly what you want to do is control other people. Yeah, that's right. Put it this way. Every time you help someone who hasn't asked for it, Every time you sacrifice yourself for someone, even though they didn't want you to, you're forcing that on them. Now, why would you do that if you're being helpful? For one reason only. You want to control them. You want them to do it your way. You want them to feel the way you're comfortable with, and so on. You need to face the facts here. Self-sacrifice is really nothing more than controlling manipulation. It's been one of the most fucked up realizations of my whole life. I spent my whole life being a self-sacrificing people pleaser, only to realize that's the most selfish thing of all. A classic example from my younger days is I used to play the counselor role. So when one of my friends, you know, got themselves into a difficult position, I'd be there like the therapist. I'd be there to help them through it and comfort them and guide them through it. And on the surface, I looked like this helpful, caring friend. But what was really happening is I was condoning their self-sabotage. I wasn't giving them the tough love that they needed. I was enabling them to continue with the poor behavior and the irresponsible decisions that led to the problems that they got themselves into. I would often support someone who's self-sabotaging just so that they could see me as the supportive person. When a genuinely helpful person would say, "Look, I can't talk to you until you sort your shit out." If any of this is resonating with you, we recommend that you check out the BROJO Nice Guy Recovery course. It's free and you get free membership with it. And that'll help wake you up to some of the people-pleasing and some of the alternative and more confident actions you can take instead to be even more helpful than you are now. Problem number three, you are going to lose yourself. The less often that you express your own needs and your own desires and your own priorities and act upon them, the more you're going to lose track of what they even are. After many years of behaving this way, you're going to become the people pleaser. That performance that you're putting on will become your actual personality. I remember waking up once, I was in my mid-20s, this actually happened on a number of occasions, but this kind of wake up in the middle of the night with this realization, I don't even know who the fuck I am. I don't even know what I like and what I dislike properly. I don't know what I stand for and against. I'm so used to adjusting to everybody else and putting everybody else's needs above mine that I don't even know what mine are anymore, which means I don't know who the fuck I am. It's a terrible thing to wake up to, and nobody else benefits from you feeling that way. Except maybe abusive psychopaths and narcissists. Maybe that's why so many nice guys and people pleasers end up with those as partners. In my work as a confidence coach who focuses on nice guys and people pleasers, I've seen a lifetime of self-sacrifice lead to so many devastating consequences. Total loneliness, midlife crises, despair and suicidality, resentment and rage. All that self-sacrifice does is build up this darkness inside of you. Especially when you're secretly hoping for appreciation and then you face the real world, which doesn't really give a fuck about you. So many of my clients, when they come to me and I ask them, you know, what their values are, what they stand for, what they believe in, what their preferences are, they're vague and unsure. They've lost who they are because I've spent so much time putting everybody else first. And they've come to me because they've hit that point finally in their life where they realize other people aren't even really benefiting from this or appreciating it. One of the wake-up calls I got in my life is I went away for 6 months, my first real overseas traveling. I went to the United States for 6 months, and when I came back to New Zealand, everybody's lives had continued without me. They had survived just fine without my help and support. And that was like a big slap in the face. Like, I wasn't there to sacrifice myself for these people, but they're okay. They didn't actually need me. And that's the deep, dark truth underneath all this. Your self-sacrificing is desperately an attempt to make people need you because you don't want to face the fact that they don't. They'll be fine without you. What to do instead? Here are some simple tips to help you break out of the self-sacrificing pattern without becoming a less helpful person or a less giving person. Number one, set yourself up with a morning routine. Make sure that your needs and your plans for the day and your kind of preparation comes before everybody else. If your children wake up really early, wake up even earlier so that you can be the one who does this. Make sure that by the time you're helping other people, you've got all your own shit sorted first. Start the day with that momentum. Queue up requests from other people. If you're a people pleaser and a self-sacrificer, you will have trained others to be needy for you and to kind of come to you rather than sorting shit out themselves. You've caused that effect. So what you can do is you can start queuing it. Never drop your tools to help someone. If you've got a plan for the day and they want your help, they have to wait until you're done, until you're free and available. Never put aside what you had planned, unless it's an absolute emergency, and trust me, most of the time it is not. What you'll notice is if someone has to wait a couple of hours, they figure it out themselves. Proof that they never needed you in the first place. Boundary setting. The greatest fear of people pleasers, being confrontational, saying no, putting a line in the sand and saying, do not cross this line. Because self-sacrifice is really about a fear of setting up those boundaries. You don't want people to be upset with you, so you just fold like a deck chair. Make sure everybody knows that if they want your help, there's a process they have to follow. And you are going to hold the boundary on that process. How they ask for it, the way they schedule their time with you, what they must accept from you, and so on. And if you're somebody who struggles with setting boundaries and doing confrontations, I've got a link below for the boundary setting course that we have in BROJO. You do need to be an advanced member to do this course, however. And in a general sense, prioritize your health, prioritize your integrity, prioritize your time management. Make it that these things come first, even above your family and your loved ones, because they will benefit if you get that shit sorted. This is for them as much as it is for you. You coming at them all tired and worn out and overworked and overwhelmed, that's not fucking helping them. If anything, you're dragging them down. Don't do that to them, and don't do it to yourself. Don't be disrespectful to yourself, because that's how you lose who you are. No one is allowed to make you compromise your principles. No one is allowed to make you neglect your health. No one is allowed to fuck with your schedule. Okay? Make that the hard and fast rule. It's not going to be other people who are uncomfortable with this. It's going to be you. And if anybody gives you a lot of shit about this, at least after the initial adjustment period of you becoming more confident, then they're probably someone who's trying to use you and abuse you. And you need to cut that person out of your life. And if you're a self-sacrificing people pleaser, you've probably got quite a few people like this in your life. So you're going to have to weed that garden pretty hard. But you can build up to that as your courage grows. Make sure that you are 100% before serving others. Then you're the most powerful server that you can be. They're going to receive the best from you that they can possibly receive. And you're not neglecting yourself in the process. Everybody wins. Anything less than that, anything in the self-sacrificing category, is no more or no less than manipulation. And if you feel resistant to this idea, it's because you're clinging to your identity, your reputation as a self-sacrificing people pleaser, a nice person, a helpful person. Let that shit go, because it is killing you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please share it around, comment below, and subscribe to the channel if you liked it. And of course, if all of this resonates with you and you need some more professional support to break through it, get in touch, dan@brojo.co.nz, and I'll help you through it one way or the other. Thank you so much. Cheers.